Welcome to ASMR Paradise Laboratories. My name is Maria and I'm a clinical associate in here. I'm going to be taking care of you. Do you feel comfortable? Yeah? I'll talk to you in a second, okay, too. So just to explain to you a little bit, here in these laboratories we collect data about ASMR sensitive people. I am personally myself an ASMR sensitive person, so I have this feeling, and I'm also an ASMR artist, so I recreate the sensation in you with the help of different triggers. So today I'm going to do different tests on you, trigger tests, to see how your brain reacts, how your body reacts as well. We're trying to collect this data because we're trying to push more research in the future to look into more ASMR programs and searches and how to implement it. And also just realizing and trying to understand deeper questions as well, such as why do some people have it and some people don't? Why, through evolution of, you know, humanity, only a certain amount of people have kept this trait, and what does it mean, how we can apply it? So we simply collect, do not interfere at all. Okay, I'll start with taking some of your information and then we'll move on to actual testing. Deal? Okay, I'm gonna lean over you a bit. Good. So I'm trying to just reply honestly. It's not to impress anyone, there is no right or wrong answer. Just, you know, be relaxed and really try to enjoy this. Okay? Good. I appreciate it. So let's start with your name. Your date of birth. Do you remember approximately your first experience? What age were you? 6 or 7. Yes, you know, majority of people remember their first ASMR experience to be around this age, 6 to 7 years old, me included. Do you remember what it was? Your teacher. Great. It is also one of the most common experiences, with a teacher or a friend, yeah, or a doctor even. Okay. So, since you are ASMR sensitive, do you happen to know if you are type A or type B? One is reacting to the sounds, external sounds or external stimuli. So when you get personal attention, get a haircut, or through videos. And the other one is when you can actually recreate the sensation started in yourself by yourself, through meditation or just through focus. The first one, okay? So you have type B. Good. Again, there is no right or wrong. Now, do you watch videos online? Okay. Who's your favorite ASMR artist? You can give me a couple. Mm-hmm. Anybody else? Mm-hmm. There's quite a few. Okay, that's fine. So, do you prefer mostly male or female voices? Mm-hmm. Now, what is your favorite trigger? You just like voices the most, yeah. You know, I'm actually quite the same way. Different triggers can come and go, but my favorite trigger will always be voice. It's just something about persona. Yeah, for you too. Good. I'm glad we have that in common. But otherwise, are there any certain sounds that you like for triggers? Haircut, great. Like faster, different, okay. I'll leave that just to be. How about crinkle sound? Crinkle. Let's see. Do you prefer soft spoken or whispered? Both, okay. Depending on the person, maybe. It happens more often, yeah, than you think. Okay. Let me see what else we have. Now, do you happen to know if anyone in your family experiences ASMR? Not that you know of. Mm-hmm. Yes, me too. Nobody in the distant, even family. Okay, I think that's all I have questions for you. Yeah, let me just double check. Okay. Another thing, are you ticklish at all? Okay, so now, let's put this away. Now is the interesting part, and this is our test now. I am going to apply electrodes onto your hand, just so that I can trace your brain activity during this procedure. Truly, nothing is expected of you, okay? So you can just lean back and just take it in for whatever it is. Don't be nervous, okay? Just try to enjoy yourself. I promise to be very accommodating and very comforting, okay? So, let me just get electrodes. So, I have this pack of electrodes. There's four of them. They come in two pieces like this, okay? You can see they're sticky on the other side. And I'm going to very carefully attach them to your temples and to the top of your head, okay? And then I will attach the ends, the cords, into my computer to record any brain activity, okay? Again, we just trace it later between your resting state and your triggered state and try to see the difference. Deal? Okay. So let me just apply it. Good. Let me do the other one.
You're a little bit sticky, so don't be surprised, okay? Let me apply this one right here. Plug this one in. Two more, but I will attach it to your head, okay, right here. So it's again a sticky one. Just going to gently press it right above your head right here. Okay. And I'm gonna attach this one. I'm gonna get the second one. Second one, the fourth one, I should say. And I'll apply this one here. Does it feel okay? Mm-hmm. And now attach the cord too. Very good. So now everything's going to be recording your reactions, okay? I hope that's okay. And from here, I'm going to try and comfort you a bit. Okay, I'm just going to cover you up. Is one of my favorite things is to be massaged before I need to relax or fall asleep. So I'll start with some massaging, okay? Some long strokes. Gently running up one side. The other side. I can do little squeezes on your legs. Now this feels very relaxing. Feels like gentle small hugs. And I'm just squeezing gently your muscles. Your legs, and your hips here. Good. And I'll just do again gentle strokes. This should feel good. Something crinkles there. Just pressing on the hips a bit. Okay.
I do like this. Just running gently up your body with these soft breaths. It feels as if little paws are touching you. Such a soft, gentle movement. Very good. Now I'm going to recline you, okay? It's time to just for you to focus on the stars there. Maybe kind of relax more. Maybe close your eyes if you wish. And I'll start doing different sounds, okay? Trigger sounds, of course. First, I'll lean you back. Be scared, I'll just reposition how your head is, okay? Alright. Okay. So, the very first thing I'm going to do is test out your reflexes to make sure that you're ready for the test. Okay. Let me just ready? Okay. If you could just follow the light for me. And again, I'm just checking it out. Real quick. Same thing on this side, right? Again, I'm just making sure that no more questions are going to be asked, okay? Let's do distance. Then up close. Very good. To test out your ears the same way we just did with eyes, but I'll come close into your ear, just flash the light and look inside of it, okay? Just gently. Same thing, okay?
looks good, but I'm going to do a little bit of brushing on your ears as well. Okay? Good. So we usually dust out with three different brushes. So I'll do a softer, lighter touch, a more heavier brush, and then I'll just do a Q-tip real quick, okay? And I'll start with a bigger brush, okay? And so again, let me just look at your ear here too. You can probably look at my ear meanwhile. Okay. So we'll just test out your touch senses, okay? So I'll do brush stroke down, brush stroke up, and then around your ear. Deal? Stroke up, stroke down, stroke around here. I did it sound okay? Let's do this one. Stroke up, stroke down, stroke around. Still good. Let's do one more time. How was that brush? Okay, good. Now I have this broom. So let's try that one too, okay? Down, up, and over. Feels alright? Great. Up, down, and over. Use a little Q-tip. Okay, just to clean around your ear. Deal? And you don't have to worry, it feels good. Usually everybody loves this part the most. Because it's such a particular, peculiar feeling. Feels good. Let's brush it again. Just gentle bristles over your ear. Still feels okay. Perfect. Now we're going to examine you on how you enjoy your tapping. Little makeup bag, and I'll be doing fast and slow tapping, and then I'm going to track how you reacted to both, okay?
our backdrop. We have the beautiful moon looking on us. Stars, big ones and small ones, and just cosmic dust particles as well. Also have some fluffy clouds, some larger clouds here, some wispy clouds in the back here even. Good. You like it? What do you think about tapping? More than you know. So try to guess. What is this finger? Remind you of? I know, tricky, huh? You can pick, no? Yes, there's a name on it. It's called Thai Marbury paper. I'm going to walk around you, is it okay? do you feel so far?
I hope that you're enjoying it. We're about to go into a sleep state.